This is the first chapter of your second term examination, chapter number 4, Mail Merge and Other Features of MS Word 2013. As I mentioned, in the syllabus of your second term, there are three chapters. Number 1, chapter number 3, this is the word processor, tabular presentation, creating and managing the tables in the MS Word 2013. Chapter number 4, word processor, mail merge and the other features of MS Word 2013. This is the chapter of our today's discussion. And the chapter number 5, presentation visual effects. These are the three chapters which are mainly concerned with the second term syllabus of your computer. From today, the syllabus of your computer second term will be covered by taking up the different classes of your computer book. This is the first class of your second term, and this is the chapter number 4, Mail Merge and Other Features of the MS Word 2013. This is the module 1 discussion, the page number 48. The learning objective of today's interactive video session is to learn about the spelling and the grammar. This is the important feature of MS Word document. As the name suggested here, the mail merge, this is the main intention of this chapter. What is the mail merge and how it should be done? Before learning about the mail merge, we have to know some important features of the MS Word document, such as number 1, spelling and grammar, thesaurus, what is thesaurus and what is the use of thesaurus in MS Word, finding and replacing the text in the MS Word document. These are the three important features of MS Word document, and after learning these important features individually, we will be heading for the mail merge, the important topic of this chapter. Clear? Now see, the MS Word 2013, it has many useful features and they are very helpful for us while we are going to create any document. Considering the MS Word 2013 document, mail merge is the important feature that can allow us to send the personalized messages to a large number of people at once or at a time. Before learning about the mail merge, we must have the clear-cut knowledge about the other important features which are related to the MS Word document. Hence, before taking up the mail merge, we will try to clear our concept about the important features which are based on the MS Word document. Among them, the most striking feature is the spelling and the grammar. How to check the spelling or how to check the grammar of the MS Word written documents by using the MS Word 2013 program or the software. MS Word 2013, this is the one kind of software or program which is used mainly in order to write any text in form of document, which is known as the MS Word document, and it has many features. Spelling and grammar, this is the feature of MS Word document. Now see, spelling and grammar, this is mainly concerned with the inbuilt dictionary of MS Word. In MS Word 2013, we will have such kind of inbuilt dictionary of MS Word 2013. While we will be writing anything about the text in form of document by using the MS Word 2013, we will see two kinds of waves. Mind it, red waves lines and the blue wave lines. I repeat, in the MS Word document format, in the text, we will see two kinds of wave lines. Number one, red wave lines, and number two or second one is the blue wave or wavy lines. The red wavy underlines indicates a misspelled word in the MS Word document, whereas the blue wavy line indicates the grammatical mistake. I repeat, in the 2013 MS Word written documents, in the text, we will see two different types of wavy lines. Number one is, the first one is the red wavy lines, and second one is the blue wavy lines. What is the significance of red wavy lines? By seeing the red wavy lines, we must understand about the spelling mistake or the misspelled word which is or are present in the written MS Word 2013 document in form of text. But whenever we will see blue wavy line, that will indicate the grammatical mistakes occurred in the text of the MS Word 2013 Word document. A spelling mistake, red wavy underline, grammatical mistake, blue wavy line. These two different kinds of lines or wavy lines are mainly used by the inbuilt dictionary of the MS Word 2013. And this feature of MS Word 2013 lets us to know about the spelling check of the words as well as to check the grammatical mistakes in the entire document or in only a part of the document of MS Word 2013 in form of text. The main objectivity of knowing the spelling and the grammar feature of the inbuilt dictionary of 2013 is to check or avoid the spelling errors, unintentional spelling errors, at the same time to make the correct grammatical use, the sense of using the correct grammatical sense in the text, to avoid the further spelling mistakes and the grammatical mistakes. Now, in order to excel this spelling and grammar feature of 2013 Word, we have to know the steps which are involved in the spelling and the grammar feature of 2013 MS Word. This is the interface of the MS Word 2013, and there are different options we can avail for different purposes, such as there is the Home tab, Insert tab, then the Design tab, Page Layout tab, References tab, Mailing tab. This is concerned with the Mail Merge, Review tab, and the View tab. And there are different groups which are mainly concerned with the different specific tasks, such as Proofing group, language group, comment groups, tracking groups, changes group, compare group, and the protect group. Mainly these are the options which are used for different purposes of the MS Word document. In order to avoid spelling and the grammatical mistakes, we have to use the review tab in order to follow the steps for the execution of spelling mistakes and the grammatical mistakes in terms of avoiding. This is the review tab, and this is the first step we must take into our consideration in order to avoid the smelly spelling mistakes and the grammatical mistakes in the written text of the MS Word 2013. First, we have to place the cursor at the location, or we can say at that fixed area of the MS Word document of the text, where we want to start the checking of the spelling as well as the grammar. This is the first step. Such as, this is the spelling task pane, and it is the written text in MS Word in form of document. The first step is to, we have to place the cursor at that location where we want to make or check the spelling errors or the grammatical errors. That means to, we have to select this location, and after doing this we have to go or head for the review tab. This is the second step. We have to click this review tab. After clicking this, we will have such kind of interface known as proofing group on the review tab. This is the proofing group on the review tab. After clicking the review tab, we will have such kind of proofing group that is open in front of our eyes. And in this proofing group, we will see this option, the spelling and the grammar under the proofing group. In the proofing group, this is the proofing group interface, we have to click the spelling and the grammar button. This is the spelling and the grammar button lies under the proofing group. The spelling task pane. This is the spelling task pane. After clicking the spelling and grammar option under the proofing group, we will have such kind of spelling task pane that will be appeared on the right hand side. See this one. This is the spelling task pane, this one, and this is the MS Word written documents. Now, after clicking the spelling and grammatical option of the grouping of the proofing group, we will have such kind of spelling task pane, and it will have different types of options such as ignore, ignore all, add, change, change all. Clear? This kind of options. This is the third step. Now we have to very sincerely know each and every options of this spelling task pane. What is the meaning of ignore? What is the meaning of ignoring all, add, option, change and change all? And this is the fourth step, and it is concerned with mainly the suggestion box, the change option, the change all option, the ignore option and the ignore all option. In this fourth step, which is involved in spelling and the grammatical mistakes, first the unrecognized word is highlighted in the MS Word document, written document. In this case, the probable and the consistent, these two words have been highlighted by using the red wavy line. And we know the significance of red wavy line is there is the spelling mistake. This is the case of spelling mistake, because we know the indication of red wavy lines is the case of spelling mistake. And this kind of things will be automatically highlighted in the region or the location of the MS Word document 2013. And at the same time, the suggestions will be displayed in the suggestion box. This is the suggestion box. And after highlighting those misspelled words, we will see such kind of suggestion box that will be displayed at the right hand side of the spelling of the MS Word document. At the right hand side, and it will be known as the spelling task pane. And after seeing such kind of suggestion box, now we have to choose and consider different options, such as the first option is to click the correctly spelled word. Probably this was the misspelled word chosen wrongly while the documents was written, and the correct word of probably is, the spelling is probably, probably. This is the correct spelling of probably, and we have to choose this correct word. This is what the meaning of this. We have to correctly click the correctly spelled word given in the suggestion box. This is the suggestion box, and the correct word is probably. This is with the correct spelling. We have to choose this word. Now we have to consider other option, such as change option, and we have to click the change option in order to change this word. In order to change this selected word, or we can also opt for the change all option by clicking this one in order to change this word for the entire document. That means we will have two kinds of options here. Either we may choose the change option directly in order to change that selected word, or we may also choose or opt for the change all option in order to make the change for that particular type of word for the entire or the whole document. Now another option for the suggestion box is ignore. This is the ignore. This is the ignore all and the add option. Now what is the necessity of using the ignore option? If we choose or click the ignore option, that will be meant that if there is no requirement of further correction, I repeat, if there is found no further requirement of doing correction, then we may choose this ignore option. Or we may choose or click the ignore all option with taking the intention of to check the documents further, but by leaving all the instances of the highlighted word unchanged. This is how we can choose either ignore option or the ignore all option, but we have to know the clear objective of using the ignore option and the ignore all option. Ignore option should be selected while there will be no correction is needed, but ignore all option may be chosen or selected to continue checking the document without leaving all instances of the highlighted word unchanged. Now the last option we have to take into consideration, that is the add option of the suggestion box. We may click or choose the add option in order to add the new word to the word dictionary. I repeat, we can choose this word add option by clicking so in order to add the new more word to the inbuilt word dictionary of the MS Word. And by clicking the desired button, this one, spelling and the grammar check complete, and you are good to do so. On clicking the desired button, the action is performed. The action will be performed, and then the next unrecognized word is highlighted. That means while the checking of spelling error and the grammatical mistake is done once, the next grammatical mistakes or spelling mistakes can also be performed by using the same process, and this is known as the repetition of the step 4 until we see a message that is saying spelling and grammar check complete and you are good to go is displayed. And finally, when all kind of spelling mistakes and the grammatical mistakes are correctly done, finally we have to click the option OK. And the feature of MS Word is spelling, checking of spelling and the grammatical, checking the grammatical mistakes will be done for that specific MS Word written document in form of text. This is the whole discussion of using the feature of spelling and the grammar of MS Word for the written MS Word documents. I hope this concept is clear. In our next video, we will be discussing about the thesaurus and the find and replace, these two important features of the MS Word. After that, we will be moving or heading for the ML merge, other striking features of this chapter 4 of MS Word 2013. Till then, thank you and happy learning.